Okay, so it's like now 1:30 at night. Took a shower and whatnot, but this is going to be on day 64 because it's actually day 64. And I felt like making everybody wait another week to actually see Prith. But this here is Within the Light. Come on now. Give me the quest complete. There we go. So some various XP. No levels, but really close to that agility level, 3K away. And now I gotta start, Plague's End. Here we go. Might just stay up late tonight. Why not? Just had to kill Bork in the Chaos Tunnels because I didn't have a single other, blue charm. So yeah, I'm doing Plague's End. I don't have another blue charm. Okay, come on, get me out of here. Okay. There it is. Complete. Oh man. Exoskeleton, yeah, give me that. Give me that. Oh. XP. 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 That's a level. That's not. That is. That isn't. That is. That's not. That's almost. Wow. Yeah, 2K away. And that's not. Alright. Three levels. Agility 77. Mining 76. That's 30K XP from Ritual of the Majorat. I was planning ahead. I know. I know. And then. Which way do I need to go? Teleport me to Prith. Yeah. Oh baby, here it is. Here it is. Got my Ellie pet following me. Woohoo! We are as one. Thank you. Sup, bruh? Oh man. I don't want to watch the cutscene. Like, I know what happens. Oh man, this music. It's so nice. The city of gainz. All right, skip the cutscene. I've seen it before. Okay, here we go. What's that? Amlod and Ithil? Nothing I can use. Yeah, nothing at all. Alright, well, I gotta pick up this lodestone. I know that was weird. I accidentally clicked the top of my window and resized it. Okay. Activate. Bam. There we go. On to the next clip. Got a few hours of sleep, and now I'm here. Doing my first task, the one that I had beforehand, and I'm trying to figure out which Slayer Master to do to push myself for Strikeworm tasks, because that's what I'm going to try to grind all weekend, over and over again, are Strikeworms. May not sound like, like much, but the idea that you get like a Slayer VIP ticket, the effect at least. For every single task you pick up, means that I can probably grind at least one of the two other Slayer helmet pieces that I need. So yeah, I'm just gonna push hard, and apparently I'm getting the plus 50% Slayer XP. You can see here, plus 196. They normally give like 120. So yeah, that's really something. Yep, so I'm just gonna be pushing hard this weekend. I'll probably throw in quite a few clips from time to time. Or I'll probably throw in clips from time to time of me doing tasks. So I'm still rendering last week's video. This clip may be a little laggy. But my first task coming back after finishing the thing. What was it? Aberrant Spectres. My task from last week. My first new one from Simona is Desert Strike Worms. So I'm going to come over here and prefer that. That way I'll get it fairly often. And then I'm going to prefer the other Strike Worm, Jungle Strike Worms, just as soon as I can. Okay, that right there. You can see how this is just the biggest troll. I didn't expect it to be like that big of a beam for the focus sight, but I see the beam and I'm like, whoa, is that it? No, it's not it. That's a clue scroll. Firmenix Slayer Dungeon. Okay, I'll go take care of that right after this task. 50 kills left. Yeah. Also, do want to note that I'm about to hit 77 strength, which is needed for King of the Dwarves, I think, is the next quest in the series, which will be some really good, like, mining, smithing XP, or whatever it is. It's a really good series. The Dwarf quests, they give a lot of XP in mining, which is normally pretty annoying, pretty slow. So yeah, 77 strength, and I'll get 45k mining, 50k smithing, 55k strength. Alright, the end of the elite clue. Let's see. And Dragon Medhelm. That's pretty bad. Yeah, that's pretty bad. I don't know whether to put the Onyx Bolt Tips in with the clue scroll tab or not. Same with, like, the Medhelm. I think I'm just going to Alxa the helmet. I'll cut the Dragon Stones. Yeah. Okay, back to more Slayer. My new task is Hellhounds. I wasn't prepared for hitting the 2K milestone. There it is, though. I'm doing harps during a Slayer weekend. Let me explain. It's because I'm uploading right now. I'm gonna be uploading for like another hour, if not a little bit more. And the lag is just really rough, like you can see here. Yeah, I don't know why I get that much lag whenever I have a fairly good internet connection, but that just happens. So I'm here to get Harmonic Dust. It's really AFK. I need 80 crafting, or 76 for Ritual of the Majorat, 80 for Invention, and I need Harmonic Dust for Crystal Tools. So it's a good use of time for now. So I got a Greater Demon's task, and I really can't pass up this opportunity to go to Krill. I mean, I'm going to be getting amazing Slayer XP there since it's 50% bonus today. First thing I'm going to do, though, is drop off these charms. Nice, up to 240. And then I'm going to go and do my Barrows. What's it called? Soul Reaper task? And then going to see if I can't get a one for Krill, so... Well, that's the fourth chest, but I mean, really? God. That's just... Oh, man. Okay, let's go get another task. Oh, my. DKs, Jad, KBD, Kree, Vindicta, and it ends on Corp. I can't do Corp, so I'm not doing that today. So, it's been a really long day. My voice is pretty worn out. Okay, beautiful Prif. I'm just going to show off a bit of what I've done. It's now Slayer Weekend, so I've been doing quite a bit. Full Slayer Helmet. Yeah, that happened. It took 5 tasks to get both pieces. Yeah. Also, Gloves of Subjugation. Cool. And another garb dropped, as well as my tab over here. I got Godsword Shard 2 to go along with 1 and 3. I got 2 of them, actually. And let's see, what else? I did my Jack of Trades. I got a lot of tortoise shells here and some more tortoise pouches. You can see I've collected a decent number of charms. Not a ton, but a decent amount. I'm up to 49 million experience, so I think I earned like 3 or 4 million today, something like that. So it's quite a bit. I'm up to 83 Slayer, 79 strength, almost 80. I got 85 defense, So I'm now using the Asylum Surgeon's Ring. And I'm up to 78 ranged. Yeah, it was just a really productive day. I streamed for 9 hours. I'm not sure if I've already said that or not. And I had a lot of fun streaming. I may do it more often. Yeah, so that's what the account looks like today. It's a really productive day. Let's see, this is Melior and Ioworth still. Gonna go make up some urns, do some fishing and cooking. Trying to get to 80 cooking. I don't think I can do it before the end of the weekend. But, you know, I'm just going to go back to focusing on Slayer. I currently have an 80 ANSI task. So I've gotten like 3 Kree kills with ranged. It just doesn't go too well right now because my gear is fairly weak. Been doing a lot of focus on ports. Making sure I'm keeping up with this. Let's see, can I trade another guy? Yeah, and what about the last one? Perfect, 100%. And ports is getting along quite well. And yeah, it's been a really productive day. So I'll make some more clips tomorrow. So currently doing harps, just because it's Ithil hour, and I'm about to go to sleep. It's finishing off this day, like, 64. It'll be day 65 because it is the 65th day. Anyway, I trained over 4 million experience today. Yeah, I pulled a million Slayer, like 1.5 million defense, like 500 or 600k strength, like a million constitution. It was a very good day. I just wanted to make a clip of that. I know I didn't make many clips for today, other than the one I just made a few minutes ago. But yeah, the rune tracker does show I cracked 4 million experience in 24 hours, and it was within about 15 hours of play, so that's pretty insane XP rates. Yeah, so back to the gains, right? Starting day 65, even though the overlay is wrong, that's my 7th kill on Armadill, but yeah, there we go, I got the gloves. nice. I'm pretty happy right now. I didn't expect to get anything from coming here. I was just doing it because I was doing AVNC tasks. My first time was only 3 kills in the instance, and then I had to leave. The next time was 4 kills. I burnt through a ton of food, but yeah, so I've got myself the Armadill gloves now. There's one piece down. Oh wow, I'm doing an elves task here, and I got 386 dragon bones as a rare drop table. Wow. Let me see. I think those are like 200 and something if you use them on an altar. 180. Yeah, 252. That's right. So 252 times 386. That's nearly 100,000 prayer there. Wow. Oh wow, I think I just got incredibly lucky. I got an attuned crystal weapon seed. So that means that's a tier 80 weapon, I think. Nice! Also just got my first crystal tool seed for crystal tools. Don't know which one it's gonna be. I'm thinking probably a fishing rod, but yeah. Things are going well. So, about to start another stream today on day 65. I'll do another update at the end of the day to show what happens. Don't actually really have that much of a plan for today, other than just doing a lot of Slayer. And I do want to point out that I changed the color of my overlay up here, so it's now purple. It makes it a lot easier to see in Prif. I didn't realize that light blue would probably be a bad color once I got here. so yeah, that's what's going on. On to the stream. And if you guys are interested in seeing me stream more often, then making clips for this series specifically. I can try to work that into my school schedule. I've got another about 5 weeks off of school, so I'll be able to stream just about any day during that through that duration. Just let me know in the comments, and my Twitch channel, if you're interested, is twitch.tv/anexoticllama. It's the same as my my YouTube username, anexoticllama. So yeah.
Alright, so I'm recording a clip for day 64, or 65, I mean, but I stayed up so long, it's like 4 a.m. right now when I'm recording this, so it's day 66. about to go to sleep. So one thing I got that I'm using Dragon Bones right now, I got like a 400 rare drop table drop for Dragon Bones, thanks to the Slayer Weekend. You can see I'm getting close to, 52.9 mil. I'm at 52.8 right now, which means I grinded out about 3 mil more XP today. One combat level away from Morvran. See, I hit 88 mage. Got 80 in both melee stats now, as well as I passed 80 range. And I'll show off some of the stuff that I got today. There's a few interesting things. I think the most interesting would be that I've done like 20 hard clues total on the account now. I got these within 10 of each other. Two Amulet of Fury trimmed. Completely separate drops, like one on clue number 9 or 10, and one on clue number 20, or 21 exactly. It blew my mind that I could get that. Two of them. I've been getting a few, what are they? Like the heraldic armor, the rune H. Got a few of those pieces. Earned a lot of GP. You see here, I have 6.4 mil, and I left 1.5 mil in miscellanea, as well as I've blown like a mil or 1.1 mil today on Heffen alone, using it on prayer. As you can see, I'm closing in on 78. So my plan for the rest of the weekend is to continue slaying. I mean, I'm now up to 86 Slayer, which is a pretty big jump from the beginning of the weekend, I think. I want to finally get that 120 out of the way. I'm on 109 tasks now, and I believe this is task 110, another elf task. Not sure if I made a clip earlier for it. I don't think I did. But I got an attuned crystal weapon seed and a crystal tool seed. These were in the same elf task earlier on, which was pretty insane. And let's see. Oh, I've done two ascension creature tasks now, and I've got two Cordis keys. That's it. It's only two, but it's something. Gotten two rare drop table lobsters, like 300 lobsters each. Which is the only way that I can keep slaying, because I'm almost out of food entirely. Let's see here. I got myself that mud pie that I needed the other day from Firewatch. I got myself the split bark helm, so I can do just about anything. Any of the clues, except for the Amulet of Glory. That's the only one that I can't do. Nothing new there. Nothing new here. You see my herbs. They're slowly building up over time. But I am going to have to start doing farm runs again before too long. And, yeah. Not much more here. That's new, at least. Oh yeah! I don't know if I clipped this. This was Armadale kill number 7. I got Armadale gloves. Which is pretty great. Yeah. So that's about it. I know this is a bit of a long clip, but it's been a long day. I think I played for like 17 hours. So, and you could probably hear that I'm fairly tired right now. So yeah, log off for the day. I'm gonna do another day, maybe even two, of streaming and playing and doing this like nightly wrap-up. I think Monday will be my day of PVM to follow all of this. I want to unlock Tuska's Wrath soon. I want to run through all of the quests that I have available soon. Try to get
the Slisk's in-game, what's it called? Early bird bonus, if I can, as well as unlocking the Sun Spear soon, and unlocking Invention before too long. So, it's kind of the plan for the week, but I don't know if it's going to all happen this week. We'll see what happens. Oh man, PK air. Really though? Okay.
So, just got done streaming for most of the day. Just gonna show off my cash stack. 9.3 mil, and I got 1.5 mil over in miscellaneous still. I've got Vampirism still active. That's no big deal. I'm gonna jack of trades soon. So today, I got a second Amulet of Fury trimmed. It was like 10 hard clues later. Let's see. I'll show my my weekend loot. Tons of charms here. Got a lot of tortoise shells stacked up for making war torts in the future. Got two attuned crystal weapon seeds, an extra crystal weapon seed, crystal tool seed. Let's see here. Lots of Addy bars, lots of mithril ore and Addy ore. Still got the same amount of raw sharks I had yesterday though, I think. Getting up there in magic logs too, and my ascension keystones. I've got four of them now. Let's see. Got a whip vine on my first Jadinko task as well. And over here in my clue tab, got another hard clue to do. I should probably go do that now. Got myself a swag and top hat. H3 plate skirt, H2 plate helm that I already had, H2 shield that I already had. Zamorak plate skirt with some Ceridoman chaps. Nothing really new here other than that. I got some Guthix arrows, which fill out my last type of arrows, god arrows, and got myself a rune cane so I can wear my pimp cane, my top hat. And here's all of the herb drops for this weekend. It's not a ton, right? And I did clean some of them, I think, so there some of these that are cleaned up here should be included. But like 138 Lance, 144 Irits. It's really nice. Got a lot of white berries without, you know, having to go do my little white berry trick that I showed off a while back. I got Armadil gloves. I don't know if I showed that off in a clip. So I have one piece of armor gear now. Yeah, so things have been going pretty well. Oh yeah, I got my gown today too, Gown of Subjugation. I already had the gloves, two garbs and two hoods, so now I've got the gown, and I've got the ward over here that I've had for a little while. Been doing a lot of court summons, which I know they're a trim requirement, so I shouldn't really worry about them. But yeah, that's what the account's looking like right now. I'm 54.7 million XP, and that port's ding right there, this is just after today's daily reset. So my ports are pretty rockin'. That is my first slate. This one's still heading out. I will set this guy up in just a moment. Yeah, you can see here, I just unlocked the current region. You can see next zone is 2%. So I've only done one. You know, my roster here is really starting to fill up. Before too long, I'll have the building upgrade, so I can have a third ship. And I even have a lacquer mission today. Also, my new daily for today. My daily yesterday was divination, but today's daily, I've already extended it after I re-rolled it into dungeoneering. Extended it. So I'm going to go do this. And the plan for the upcoming week is to finish a lot of quests. Finish the elite. I think if I can do the elite wilderness tasks, I will. Otherwise, I'll just go up too hard. Put all of that on Herblore. Then I'll put my daily Jack of Trades on Herblore, as, you know, as normal. And then I'll put on Ritual of the Majorat experience onto Herblore. And that should get me most of the way, if not all the way, to 80. Which, 80 is my last requirement for Slisk Endgame, which comes out in about 9 hours from now. So we'll have to do The Light Within,
which also means 80 agility, getting to about 84 crafting, and then boosting to 89, which is going to be a little difficult, and then the rest of the way to 80 woodcutting doesn't take too long. So yeah, the account's looking really good. This week's going to be a lot more skilling. I know I've been doing a lot of Slayer recently, but it was Slayer weekend. You know, I kind of had to, right? Yeah, so I'm going to sign off for tonight, unless more stuff goes on. I'm going to play for about 4 more hours. I just stopped streaming because there's a Netflix show that I started watching this morning. I want to finish up. Yeah, and total level 2032 now. Oh yeah, I did get combat 120 because I hit 89 mage, which means I have access to Morvran now. So you can see I've got a Water Fiend's task from Morvran, and I'm just holding on to that until I get familiarization ticket again. Yep. On to the next clip. Also, as for this week's Day of PVM series, it might be delayed. I'm planning on getting Chaotic Crossbows before too long. I need 95 Dungeoneering for the Garageo Resource Dungeon, and getting to 95 is going to get me probably both Chaotic Crossbows. So after I get Chaotic Crossbows, I plan on doing a Day of PVM with stuff like Armadil. Maybe I can go Mage Bandos, because I think maging Bandos is a good idea. I might even try maging like Vindicta, which is, I know, is a little crazy. But God Wars Dungeon 2 is like the next step in my progression, PVM-wise, so we'll see what happens there. But the series might be delayed a little bit. It may not come out on Monday or Tuesday. That's okay. It was meant to be more of a supplementary thing, not necessarily weekly. Not every weekly on the day like this one is on Fridays. So if you are interested in that series and the continuation of it, I will note that it may be delayed at times, or it may have more than one episode a week at times if people are more interested in it. Or I could just supplement in streaming instead of making that series. You know, we can discuss it in the comments if you're really interested in my account and the progression and stuff like that, getting more content out of me. Just let me know your thoughts. So, been doing this and that. Just turned in a Teak Magic Wardrobes daily I've had for a long time. Let's see, 123 Mahoganies, that's pretty good. For a little while, I've been working on getting my statues for the week taken care of. I'm gonna go turn these all in. Let me see. I let a Admiral Pie thing expire. I wasn't paying enough attention. So rip the Admiral Pie daily, but at least I don't have to deal with it now. Gonna do a little bit of cooking, and once I get to 78 cooking, presumably I can. I think I can with what I have here banked. Then I'm going to use the banner boost and cook the shark with the cooking gloves. Most of them will probably burn. Maybe like cut 50 off the top of this at least. But at least, you know, I can now have shark as a food. I'm also going to do a lot of fletching to maple short bows, not maple shield bows. If you're Ironman, you want maple short bows for invention. And then I'm going to push towards invention with the mithril addy ore that I have here, the mithril addy bars, and the coal in Artisan's Workshop. And I may even end up mining some coal for Artisan's Workshop because I need 81 mining before long for what's it called? The daily crystal flasks. So yeah, just like I said, got a lot of stuff to work on now that the Slayer weekend is pretty much over. I mean, it's still running for another 6 hours, but I'm not going to deal with it anymore. I want to do some other skilling stuff. So turning in the Dungeoneering challenge that was extended. Oh my, that's a lot of XP. It's a little less than I thought, but that's, you know, come on now, 180k almost? It's pretty good. I got all of my strange rocks except for smithing, and I blew through like all of my smithing materials trying to get it. I've got like 2k iron left or something like that, but I blew through all of my coal and all of my mithril, or almost all of my mithril. All of my coal and definitely all of my adamantite. Yeah, don't know what I'm going to work on now. Probably going to sleep because it's like 2 a.m. But I know that for Saren dailies from now on, I'm going to be running the agility course, and every time I get the chance, I'm going to be crafting harmonic dust. Yeah, so on to the next day. So, starting day 67, and I was wrong in a lot of the past clips. There's no early bird bonus for Slisk's in-game, which is now out, and a lot of people are complaining about. So I'm going to push for the requirements over time, but it's not something I'm going to try to get done within the next 2 weeks, necessarily. But you can see I'm doing harps right now, which I should retune and go do some agility instead, because it's half an hour. And Heffen agility is something that you can't really miss as an Ironman. So I'm going to go work on that. I got some friends that I'm going to go see in a few hours. And then once I get back this afternoon, I'm probably going to be doing, a lot of questing. So I've got quite a bit of requirements for quests out of the way. Probably at least 20 to go through right off the bat. That's the plan for now.
So, it's now really late in the day. It's actually after the daily reset. I need to go get some more Vizwax, because my new daily is Blood Runes. It's pretty gross. Just going to take anything else over that, because I don't want any more Rune Essence. I think I can go do these Strange Rocks right now, which I'm going to. I feel like doing the whole hour of Heffen, because Heffen Agility is, like, the best thing ever. I think I've already explained it before. But basically you get 20% of your agility experience. You know, you're getting plus 20% agility from the Heffen course, and then you get 20% of that agility as prayer, like as an extra bonus. So prayer XP will be pretty good. I think if I spend all of my gold right now, I'll be well into the 80s doing Saren Stones. 92 is the goal. Let's see if I can finish the statue right now. Yeah, there we go. Another explosion taken care of. I think that's number 9? No, it's got to be number 8, because this is week 9. Going to start a lot of quests, so expect to see a lot of clips from the rest of this evening. Hey, I need my my piece. Where's my thing? There we go. Not sure what order I'm going to do them in. Maybe just alphabetically, probably in the order of the quest list that I have. And time for that.
Completely forgot to record the post-quest screen. but I just got the 60k XP lamp. And I'm collecting the little post-quest rewards for Death of Chivalry. Are these... Okay, good. Just glad those aren't, stuff to fill up my bank. If they were, I would destroy them, because my bank's getting really full. Like, I need to buy bank boosters, but I can't afford that right now. On to the next quest. I totally skipped the quest dialogue again. I didn't even intend to. It just kind of happened. Like I pressed the space bar or something, and yeah. So I've completed Olaf's quest now. So that's taken care of. Those are some really interesting trees. They've been like that for a few days. I remember coming back, coming over this way. Someone said, you know, go look at. Someone mentioned the armadillo up here at the top of the little tower thing here. It looks pretty cool. And, I noticed these trees are kind of screwy. That's a thing. And there's the end of a void dance, which gives all kinds of EXP. I don't know if I can actually redeem this, these commendation points. Let me see. Where is it you go for pest control? It's like, over here somewhere? No, exchange. Yeah, you just right-click on one of them and exchange. I get 3 commendations. Oh, I guess that's from me, previously doing this. I'd like to redeem this commendation. Okay, cool. So these 50, I think I can use these for the, I can use these for the armor eventually, so I'm just going to hold on to them, not use them for EXP or anything like that, even though this, like, what is that, like 60k XP on, like, strength or something like that? It's pretty tempting. I'll just hold on to it. And there's the end of the Great Brain Robbery. cool. Got a blessed lamp. I think it gives XP. Yeah, let's see. 5k herbler. Nice. Getting really close to that next level, the 700 XP away. Don't think I need this anymore. I'm wondering, like, do I get the barrel chest anchor as a weapon now? Yeah, I'm not worried about it. I don't want it anyway. Okay, on to the next quest, and I need to update my overlay. And there's the end of Glorious Memories. Don't know what this is. Oh, 3 chapters. Oh, let's see. What do I need? Strength is about to level up, so I guess I can put it on strength. Cool. And 2 more chapters. I can't put it on magic. I can put it on ranged. I'll just put it on ranged, because I want to get ranged up. Sure. Cool. On to the next quest. Looks like I got 2 leveled ups too. Oh yeah, that's the end of the herb lore level. Nice. And a combat level. And there's the end of Dishonor Among Thieves. I thought it was more XP than that. Let me see. 1500. I thought there were more quest rewards. Maybe they are. Oh hey, that would have been nice like ages ago. Oh man, doing my Bizwax to reroll from Blood Runes, and got my first Herblord daily in a long time. Don't think I have enough to extend it right now, so I'm not going to do it. Wait till tomorrow, do Bizwax again, and extend it. Also, I need to change it over to day 68. My sleep schedule is kind of off right now because I've been staying up late for the Slayer weekend, so I'm just going to like stay up all night and correct it. I am level 2043. Yeah, so it's pretty much day 68. I mean, it's like 3 a.m., so yeah. And I lied. I had exactly, 1 more Vizwax than I needed to extend it. So let's turn in that challenge. There we go. 51k Herblore. God, that's so good. And then, well, 10 quorms for my, like, 20 Lanodimes isn't a great trade, right? But I'm not worried about it. You get a lot of Lantadimes once I start, like, being able to kill QBD, and I can do, like, QBD on Reaper tasks, or, Black Dragon Slayer tasks. I'll get a lot of Lantadimes from that, because she drops, 50 at a time. Just started off the day, I ended up going to sleep, so now I'm starting the day, something like that. Did my Nimi Forest, and, gonna go do a farm run, since I'm still in Lunars. And then move on to probably more questing. Might end up doing like Ritual of the Majorat today. I've got all the requirements for it, except for maybe Rocking Out. That sounds right. No, the temple's at Sinistan and Rocking Out. Okay, then go up to that and just take care of a lot of the rest of these quests. Get to knocking them out because there's only like 27 left. I restarted Dimension of Disaster. But, you know, I actually have finished it. Okay, on to that. So, I would have started questing, but I saw it was Amlot Hour, and because I'm always, like, urged to take advantage of the good hours here in Prif, like whenever Heffen comes up and stuff like that, I decided to do some summoning. You can see I've got a 800 granite lobster pouches, and I only had, like, 200 or something when I started. Burned through, like, 5 mil cash here. Which doesn't feel too great, but I'm about to get a lot of it back. And here is level 78, which is just enough to be able to swap back these granite lobsters. So I'm going to trade them all. I can keep these just fine, and then I'm going to sell back the all of these spirit shards. Okay, cool, I got back 2.7 mil, so I only burned through like, I don't know, maybe a mil gold there. Not too bad. And I got like 3 summoning levels. And there's the end of Temple at Sintiston. Pretty good XP here. Let's use the combat lamp on, I think, summoning. Because, I mean, it's probably the hardest thing to level up of all of the combat skills. And 23k, let's put that on our blower. I mean, is there any other option? Let's read this book, I guess. Yeah, because that's for curses. So now if I pray over here, I get ancient curses. Nah. I don't need to use them. I think it's better to use this spellbook unless like the change in DPS from using like Rigor down to a leech is outweighed by the damage a boss does to itself from a deflect. It's something like that. So I mean, I think I'd use them for Cree if I go back to Armadyl. But other than that, they're probably not worth using for Normal Slayer and whatnot. So on to the next quest. And there's the end of rocking out. Soon, there's the XP drops at least. All right, this little cutscene thing going on. Come on, I want the quest in screen. I remember this happening the last time I did the quest that like this is the thing. Okay, a few seconds later, there is the end of rocking out. Awesome. And there is 76 fishing out of the way. Allows me to catch sharks, and since I have 76 agility, up to 2 sharks. This has been something I've just working towards for a little while, and finally got it. I'm going to keep using my miscellanea on fish for a little while, on tuna and swordfish, because I don't have enough raw fish to actually get to 80 cooking to make sharks. But hopefully I'll get there before too long. Back to a little more questing though. I just took a break from questing, do some AFK stuff for a while. It seems I've gotten a lucky challenge here for God Wars. I think it is. I'm pretty sure if it's something like God Wars or Barrows or something like that, it's gonna be a lucky challenge. Not sure if this is worth keeping or re-rolling. I'll ask a few people's opinions and seeing what the XP reward is, but I thought it would be cool to point that out. Also, divination challenge. Turning that in. Brilliant memories, 17K, no big deal. So I just got 78 crafting because I'm pushing for that like 80 or 84 requirement really that I have for some remaining quests. And 78 allows me to boost with a crafting potion to make the highest level of cooking urn, which is going to be good for all of the cooking that I can do of the stuff I fished earlier. Yeah, and I'm getting close to my first what would that be? Crystal tool, either the crystal pickaxe or the crystal hatchet. It's probably going to be the pickaxe because I need a higher mining level really soon. I will go for like 80 wood cutting, but getting 80 wood cutting isn't so bad compared to like, 81 mining. Doing my weekly Tears of Guthix, since the week reset happened, just 2 hours ago. And there's 26.6K farming. I know it's not it's not a level anymore. But it's still about half a level, and it's pretty good to do every single week. It only takes a few minutes for really good XP drops. Ah, look at all the presents and mayhem going on. Oh, it's such a wonderful time of year. Wonderful. There's the end of Ritual of the Majarut. Fantastic XP, access to Glaceors, Bane Ore, and 80K Herblore. 80K Herblore, and yeah, I'm sure y'all can guess. 80K Herblore. Absolutely fantastic. I'm at 79. That's awesome. Let's see, anti-poison plus plus. I think that's good for a Raxor? Eh, something like that. I'm not gonna worry about it though. Before long, I'll probably get the Venom Blood perk, so I don't even have to worry about that kind of thing for a Raxor. Yeah, I guess I'll go back to the next quest or something like that. And there's the Wilderness Easy Diaries. Don't know why I wanted to do it. It's just some good XP. And doing the Wilderness Diaries is actually part of my plan for 80 Herblore. I need 80 Herblore for what quest is that? The light.
Within the light, the light within? Yeah, the light within. There we go. 80 herblore, then it'll be 80 agility, 80 prayer. That's like no problem. 80 crafting, you know, slowly on my way there. 80 wood cutting, and then I can do this quest. This quest is. What's it leading to? Children of Ma, right? Yeah, it's the last real quest I have to do for Children of Ma, which will be lots of extra XP for Herblore, and then Children of Ma. Eventually I'll get to Slisk's endgame. It's not just 80 crafting that I need for this, though. It's like 84, and then a plus 5 spicy stew, or 86 and a crafting potion. Yeah. Doing stuff. Making gains. Got some very valuable bloodweed here, that I'm using for a, wilderness task set. And, wow, that's a lot, I think. I'm just going to, go ahead and do this. I gotta grind it, and use that. There's the medium task set, and I think I have two things left for the hard. Make a camouflage potion, which I'm going to go catch the black salamander right now, and then defeat a tormented wraith, which won't take too long, so I'll have the wilderness hard task set complete. And there we go, there's the wilderness sword 3 achieved. Got a bunch of XP to put on Herblore. Come on, and not quite 80. There's 80. Now, I think I'm going to put this on Herblore. I'm considering smithing right now, because I want 80 smithing for invention. And I need like 80 and 82 smithing. You know, let's see, that's 186k from the next level. And I think I'll put it on smithing. I won't regret that. Cool, there's a smithing level as well. And I should update my overlay, because I'm now level 20, 57. There's a river of blood, and I can make perfect juju mining potions once I get 75 farming. Oh wow, starting off day 69, dank memes. I got 34,000 thieving XP from a pyramid plunder challenge I've had for a little bit. I didn't know it was going to be that good. That's quite a bit of XP. And there's the end of dealing with Scabbergas. Okay, on to the next quest. Alright, I'm here at Lady Ithil. I got the 4,000 harmonic dust I need. Going to upgrade my dragon pickaxe. Awesome. So now I have a crystal pickaxe on my tool belt. Got another few hours of grinding, or I guess AFKing, it's not grinding, to go here at Ithil, but I'm only doing it on Ithil hours. So it's going by pretty quickly, and I need to get higher crafting anyway. And there's the quest King of the Dwarves. That's taken care of. Got a mining level, 77. That is for Bane Ore and Harmonized Coal, which will be good for Treherne hours, because I need coal for smithing. And it gave me like 55k smithing, which has me pretty close to smithing 74. Only about 900k to go until invention. I forgot to make a clip, but I've only been here at Lava Flow Mines maybe like 20 or 40 minutes, something like that. I just got the golden mining boots. There's like 1 out of 5 done, and it took less than an hour. That's pretty good. Still over here at Lava Flow Mine, just doing some AFK stuff because there's no Heffen or Ithil hour going on. I should go ahead and get this golden mining suit. And I do need 81 mining for something? Birthright of the Dwarves, I think? That's 80. It's something like that. There's something I just wanted to throw this clip in, because I absolutely love doing this. And just scrolling through slowly. Because on my other account, I never really did that many quests until I really had to, right? I wanted to push for, like, Dragonbane Bolts, and I was like, oh, fine, I'll go do some quests. But seeing as I pushed out all of these already, and I'm not even to the end of week 10, it blows my mind.
Now that I am 77 mining, and I have been for a little bit now, on Trahearne hours, I'm going to be mining harmonized coal, which that rock just died. But you can see I'm collecting quite a bit. I've got 150 corrupted ore here already, 350 coal. That's so that I can continue doing Artisan's Workshop with like adamant ore and mithril ore whenever I get it from Slayer and Bossing. And I'm using a friend's chat for it. It's called Trah Fun. That's T-R-A-H, like Trahearne, space fun. And yeah, you can see here, Trah Fun. And basically, they just call out whenever there are harmonized rocks. And they see them, they call them out, and you can go hop to those worlds and get some good mining XP. Alright, just did a daily challenge for Charm Sprites. Going to turn that in. It's supposed to be pretty good XP. Yeah, 32.3k in Hunter. It's always appreciated.
So, starting off day 70, and I have now finished off all of Doric and Boric's tasks for smithing and mining XP. I accidentally put 15,000 bonus XP towards mining. It's not horrible, but the rest I put on smithing. So you can see here I've got, where is it, 119k bonus smithing. Going to go burn through that, and yeah, I'm really trying to push for that 80 smithing goal that I have. You can see it's now 75. So I think I'll be putting my Jack of Trades on it the next like day or two that I do have it. I know I'll go take care of this Water Fiends task for more mithril ore. I'm going to take advantage of Trahearne hours to mine more coal at harmonized coal rocks. And I'm also pushing towards that 81 mining so I can start getting my daily crystal flasks. So this is probably going to be one of the last clips for this week because, well, I don't see much else happening tonight. But I'm sure some people are interested, seeing as this is now the end of week 10. My account has 29 days and 22 hours of playtime. That comes out to, let's see, 718 hours of play. And if I divide here, about 59.8 million over that 718, that puts me at about 83.3k XP per hour on average. And that's including doing, you know, all of the quests that I have, which, you know, almost all of them. Yeah, some interesting stuff. Actually kind of proud of myself for being pretty efficient throughout that entire time. And I know some people are interested in that kind of, like, account efficiency number. And it'll only continue to go up over time. But now, total level 2067, and that's what it is at. I'm getting really close to that 60 million. Don't think I'll make a clip for it, because, you know, it's just another 10 million, and they're going to start flying by pretty quickly.
Oh, this is so perfect. I got an Iron Ceremonial Sword Smithing Daily Challenge. You can see I'm starting to do the Tuska's Wrath push, and I'm going to try to get the next thing, too. What's it called? Sacrifice and Devotion. I'll just leave the other one. That means I have like 9 more runs of this to go. I'll space it out over time a little bit. It's not too big a deal. Definitely going to extend this Iron Ceremonial Swords daily. Perfect timing for my you know, push to 80 smithing. And since it's half an hour, just wanted to make a quick clip of me finishing off 80 prayer, showing I'm working towards 80 agility as well. I spent a little bit of gold to get to that, the rest of the way to 80 prayer, but that's no big deal. Oh, light form. Yeah, that's right. That's a thing. Getting really close to 80 crafting, but I still need like 84 to 86, which is, you know, well over a million away. And okay, back to that smithing daily. Gonna get a lot of mining XP out of it too, because I have like I don't know, 1,000 iron ore or something like that to mine to actually finish it. So I'm here mining iron ore, and I just remembered that
I should be going back to temple trekking. This is a complete waste of time right now. Honestly, like the hard temple trekking tokens give what is it, 20 to 60 iron and 40 to 120 coal, both of which I need tons of. I think I need a few thousand coal right now, something like that, to get the rest of the way to 80 smithing. I could be wrong. I could do it in another way. Yeah, I'm gonna go do this for a little bit and then back to smithing. So as you can see, this is the third run of temple trekking that I've done since I just started, and yeah, I've already got two pieces of the lumberjack set. I've got one in the bank, so that means I have one to go. I'll definitely get it while leveling these two last followers all the way, though. Got the easy and medium, and both versions, the Bergdoraut Ramble and Temple Trekking. Got them up to level 99. I've just got the last two hard guys left to go. Just finished my Iron Ceremonial Swords daily challenge. Gonna turn this in. I got 491k left to go. Let's see, is this gonna be like 80k? 33. Oh, that's really sad. I extended it hoping for a lot more. Oh wow, that's a lot of rune though. Oh my gosh. Okay, I'll take that. My runite ore is starting to build up. You can see my corrupted ore building up. Yeah, gonna go do some more smithing. Use my jack of trades on smithing. Nice, doing some barrows for a reaper task and got a Darox plate body. Oh man, that's pretty good. That's five chests and six to go. And this should be the end of the Barrows Reaper assignment. Take all, that's a really crappy loot. Okay, cool. Eight more Reaper points. That took forever. I had 10 total to kill, but I ended up having to kill 13 because I don't know, some of the chests weren't working. Like I'd get this the symbol the thing here, the chest is now empty. And then I'd kill the last guy, and then I'd go to the loot interface. It would close out because like I was getting an XP drop or going out of combat. And then I'd open it, loot it, and I would get nothing. So just a fair warning if you have a Barrows assignment that may happen. And I'm gonna get the new Reaper task. Let's see, 28 from Krill. I mean, I can do that, but do I wanna? I'll go for a different one. Why not? 8 from Araxor, no chance. 18 from Helwer, probably not. 6 from Telos, no. 12 from Twin Furies. 14 from Giant Mole. Cool, I'll do the Giant Mole because it'll give me the White Lily seeds in the end. And this is going to be the last clip of this week. This is my current smithing. I've got 450k left to go. So that's going to take a little bit of time. But that's my next goal right now. It's getting invention. So thanks for watching, y'all. Leave a like if you liked it. Leave a dislike if you got upset at all of my streaming and not actually showing much progress. Then again, it's quite a long episode regardless. And yeah. Till next week.